Was it?
Yes.
Go on, tell us what about your fear, and have they enjoyed it yesterday?
Yesterday I was a bit apprehensive about coming because Alex had already been coming here. Me and Alex have been on a massive roller coaster journey in our relationship, and we broke up before Alex came the last time. Anyway, a while went by. I'm going to tell you this yesterday, but
that's okay.
I was on my own, it was over, and I had a lot of issues that have been haunting me for many years, that I've had trauma, unresolved trauma. Alex has been really understanding, but I've given a hard time. I'm fierce. It's not something I'm proud of, but I've had to learn to be an alpha female and stick up for myself in martial arts. I've had to fight with men, blah, blah, blah. Well, it's got the blunt end of that stick, even though he's probably the most decent guy I've ever met, and all my family agree. Anyway, God came to me, and I've been reading the Bible ever since we broke up, getting closer and closer to Jesus, and God said, you've got to go back to him. And I was like, after a while, and everything, I'm processing everything, and it's like, right, okay. Anyway, I was waiting and waiting and waiting, and it's like, it's not time. It was almost like a bowl was being pulled back and the tension was like this. It was after the full moon that I noticed, I thought, tension's gone, reach out now. And somebody said, no, not yet, it's not time. So I left it about another 3 weeks. I wrote him a message. I wrote him loads of messages, but never sent them. And God is like, now or never. And this is the 11th hour, that's what God kept saying. This is the 11th hour where it's deader than dead, and only God can save our relationship, because we made vows in the name of Jesus, just on our own with a witness, because we didn't want a big fancy wedding. I've been married 3 times, that's part of my trauma. I've got ADHD that I found out recently. I've had abortions in the past, I've been raped, I've been beat up, I've been strangled, I've been left, been through a lot. So I told him yesterday, and Alex still went through his rough last night as well.
Can I carry on? I'm just telling you.
I'm glad you asked me to come and do this.
It doesn't matter. Yeah, good, everybody's enjoying it. No, you might not be.
I'm going to tell stories. But yeah, ultimately, I'm going to really sit with myself and shed all that. It's going to be a process. It's not going to happen. It's a miracle. I can feel that Alex knows there's a shift in it, but I've still got that alpha female, that fighter. Because I had to stick up for myself so much against these men or whatever. I'd like to be the mother and the father. I've been skeet, I can't work, I've got a disabled child, blah, 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 all these things. And it's like, I just can't get going. Anyway, so yesterday, and I told you what I could yesterday. And so,
you're and telling me more now, aren't you?
Anything else? Have I missed anything else that I said yesterday? And I was on the floor, and I'm shaking a little bit. And I don't cry. Do I cry? I'm so tough. So when I cry, it's just amazing, because I don't cry. And I was just sobbing. And my throat, I mean, frozen. Trauma freezes people. And so Jesus is saying, I'm going to defrost you. I'm going to melt you. So when the tears come, that's a good sign for me. Yeah, that's it. So I'm going to take this back, reflect on everything. I'm definitely coming back in April. I feel the presence of God here. I trust you. We don't get that everywhere. So thank you. Well, amen. Jesus.
Well, all as you said, we didn't pray about that. I pray God will set you free from now, and He'll continue to heal you. You know, tears, if God gives you tears to cleanse you, to heal you, to let them flow. We don't mind, everybody else in here cries. We all cry for you because we love you.
Yeah.
Isn't that good?
Well, you bless my words.
Well, I'll bless you with some words.
For our
well, let me think about it. I'm not now. But
not now.
Later. Yeah. Well. Listen, all the blessings in the Bible. Every one of God's promises are for you.
Yeah.
I can't bless you, I can say something, but I can't bless you like God wants to bless you. it's absolutely wonderful that you've rescued you and you've brought you here to receive it.
Yeah. Yes.
I'm going to ask you a question now. Blackpool. What is Blackpool famous for? Stanley Matthews, footballer.
Yeah.
Lovely. Let's give her a capture, Rick. Isn't it wonderful how Jesus rescues people and these rescues ordinary people like you here and us to rescue somebody and see that life totally changed? Nothing can do that. Doctors can't do that, you know. You know, I often say when I'm preaching in a miracle service that what do doctors do for a blind person? They give them a white stick. What does Jesus do for a blind person? Set them free so they can see. Amen. Jesus is a better healer than any medical profession. Even though we praise the medical profession, we thank them for it. But Jesus is better. So we're going to have one more testimony. Who do you think that's going to be, Fred? You're right. It's going to be Fred. Wait a minute, you're a bit of a shorty, aren't you?
Yeah. I came at the instruction, in a way, of the Christian counsellor. And one of the things in my heart, two of them I got rid of them yesterday, and that was fear and the bastard curse. But the fear was the one that's been with me all my life, because it was the kind of fear, say for instance, I was asked a question, I'll just say, have you taken the jab? Now, I keep quiet because I thought, I'll be diplomatic and then I won't get in trouble. And I did that lots of times. When I was asked questions, I take the diplomatic route, so I wouldn't say anything. And over the years, I gained a hard heart, because sometimes I lacked the empathy to pray with people. And it was noticeable, I didn't notice till it was pointed out, my voice didn't show empathy when I was with people. And they could have been suffering really bad, and it wouldn't come out. But in the last few months, God's been doing a lovely work that I'm crying more. I never used to cry. And yesterday, I came to the front, tears were the furthest thought from my mind. But after Andrew prayed with me, I just cried, because it's a kind of relief. And I like what Pastor said when he said, God gives us tears to cleanse us. And I thank God for cleansing me, because I've had a lifetime built up of holding in emotions, believing a lie of my family over things, which we haven't got time to discuss now, but I was told lies. And yet to come into freedom from lies, and I thank you. I thank Jesus for what he's done in my life. I thank Jesus that he's brought me into a place. I'm in the age of grace, literally. I've reached 70 plus. So I am in the age of grace. And I've said, Lord Jesus, don't take me home till I'm 80, because I want to make up for the years I've lost. I want to make up for those years that the locust is away. I want to restore to me the miracles that I should have had in my 20s and 30s. And Lord Jesus, do the thing I'm asking. Say, Lord, don't let me die in bed and for people to come and find a load of worms in bed. Tell me when I'm going home, and then I'll be able to say to my family, I'm going home such and such a time, the Lord's told me. And they won't find anyone in bed. They'll just know that I've gone home to be in glory with Jesus. And it's so freedom to talk like that. I couldn't pray like that until I heard the woman say the same in a testimony. She asked the Lord, tell me, Lord, when I'm going home. And so the Lord told her. And she called her family together. And they rejoiced together. And she went home. So, Lord, that's for me. So thank you, Lord, that I'm here. I've had a marvellous time in many ways, and I've made so many good friends, including Pastor David. And I'm looking forward. I've definitely, God willing, I'm back in on the 29th, in Jesus' name.
Amen. Amen.
Do you mean back here in April?
8th of the year.
Not the 29th.
Yeah,
8th of the year. Yes, absolutely wonderful. Tony, he said he's in his 70s. Tell him how long we're going for. What are we claiming to live for? How long?
You could have me.
Yeah, all of us. You and me. Minimum of what?
How many years?
Years.
Yeah, years, yeah.
I'm doing. Oh, he knows the time. Not me.
All right. Moses had 120.
Yes, I know he did, but the thing is, you asked me what I thought. I'm living to please the Lord. I'm not living to have the
other.
And to win as many souls for the Lord as I can.
Yeah, look, probably longer than 120 then.
Well, 120 is just not.
120 of you, if you want it. Yes. 120, so you're only halfway through your life, aren't you?
Yeah.